Collegiamo qua, ma dove stai?
Buscando lei.
Thank you. Thank you. Then we come to the whole sound part, because now we still don't talk about why we choose the sounds that we choose.
Well, as you already heard in the video, the basic elements of our performance consist of the instrument of the dancer, the instrument of a live musician, in this case bansuri, classical Indian flute, and electronics. First we had an idea like what kind of concepts we want to work with here, and we started we want to do something with tradition versus modernity. At the time we were sort of working on this project, there were certain changes going on in the world, especially in the Orient, which inspired cultural perspective. So we tried to work to get influence from India, especially on the tonal part, like we chose India, North Indian raga to get our tones and our structure from to begin with, but also the rhythmic part.
So instead of a keyboard, or instead of plugging cables, you could put matrix pins in between. So he thought, wouldn't it be wonderful if those things would go instead of through the pin, through my body, right? Cut a long story short, this thinking part of the electronics, as it sort of started to be known, basically what it does is it looks at your galvanic skin resistance, which we all have, which Charles sort of discoveries in consumer electronics in our field, because what's in here is not an oscillator. Light is part of the way it's playing. So there's a little attempt at looking at complexity by another feedback mechanism. And that's very specific in the sense that, because the light in this example also feeds the battery, so electronics and the light are on the same circuitry. As you play, you will discover this in your board, as you play, crackle box eats a lot of battery life, so it changes the battery. So it's totally bad as a science device because it's not stable, right? Which makes it interesting. As the light sort of eats the
an artist or designer, then
gradually. Basically, we've been making music my whole life, but always I'm not affiliated with anything, so I have got my own studio. I collect musical instruments.
Always think about how we work. And process, and to the way I make music, and I think the
statement moving too. Because I came in Germany for a few years, so it was a joy. I didn't even realize she was going to be here. I just found that out this morning, so I'm very happy. I'm just happy to be here. Nice to meet you all.
Hello, my name is Per. I'm from Sweden. Composer, sound of
it. I don't want to bother with sensors. You don't have time for that. You can start making sound right now. Crackle Clack is there for you. So those are the three basic chunks that we're going to be working with. I just want to go through the kit with you real quick, just to make sure that everybody has all their components. Because these things are where you might get a new component, and it's good that we all are on the same page before you start soldering. Don't open your bags yet. I know, well, little baggies, don't open them yet. I know it's really tempting. So you all have the PCBs, yeah. Does anybody not have the PCB? Printed circuit board. Okay. This little box is your speaker. Does anybody not have a speaker? Okay, we're doing good. Battery, also very important. Your battery compartment. A red and a black wire, these are going to be your speaker wires. Okay, cool. And the baggie full of good stuff. So now you can open up the baggie. Very carefully empty it out onto the big white piece of paper so you can keep everything in order. So we have an on-off switch. Does everybody have the on-off switch? It's has three little contacts on it. Old school on and off switch. Everybody's got it. Cool. Capacitor, 2.7 nanofarads. So capacitors are these little guys. They look they're like little plastic houses. Little square houses.
The blue ones.
So you're looking for the one that's 2.7. This is not it. You'll see it says 2N7.
But is it black or blue or green?
It's gray. So the gray one is your 2.7 nanofarad capacitor. And a capacitor is basically like a little mini battery that can charge up with electrical currents very quickly. I'll explain what a capacitor is. So a capacitor, this is the electrical symbol for a capacitor. And the electrical symbol for a capacitor is this because it represents two electrically charged plates. And basically what happens is you feed a current to this side and charge builds up on the plate until it reaches a certain level where it discharges. So it's like a built rail. And this will also all become clear when you start putting the pieces into the board, because only certain pieces will fit. It's like then the two 10 nanofarad capacitors, the blue ones. Now the 220. This is true. Yes. So we really like peanuts.
So you can peel it.
Yeah.
I wouldn't eat it if that's what you're trying to ask. And all the resistance does is once you have electronic current running through something, sometimes the current is moving too fast and you need to slow it down to do something useful with it. All the resistor does is slow down the current and dissipate it as heat. We also have this variable resistor, also called a trim top. It looks like a little black square with like a little white circle in the middle that you might be able to put a key into. Nobody's really going to have to worry about this part. The only reason we have this part in there is in case you want to use a different op-amp with the circuit. And in that case, you can use this to do some tuning. For this workshop, you can just completely ignore this part. Or if you really want to fuck up the circuit, you can put it in there and play around with it. transistors are these little kind of like black semicircular things if you look at them from the top with three legs. And the
PMP, which is the
PC557, is one that says 557 on it. And then the NPN transistors are the other ones, the ones with the shorter legs. One on the Crackle back, and then you put a male on the Crackle hack, and then you can connect it to the them. And that's how you can mix and match which boards you use. So I think that's everything.
No, the chip itself.
Oh, the chip itself, right. Very important. Okay, this chip is, well, they don't really make them anymore. So we have to dig around quite a lot. Actually, the last time I flew to the United States, I ransacked some warehouses and got a buttload of them. But they're very hard to find. So, lucky.
The interesting thing about the chip is, in the 70s, they made this. This is an op amp, which is used for everything, for all sorts of electricity, sort of different adaptations. And in this version, the way that the filter gets stabilized, I mean the chip gets stabilized, is external. So externally you connect the filter, actually two filters to this chip, so that the feedback, that's actually how it's working, that gets regulated externally. That's what we're using by touching some of those connections. You're part of the filtering of the op-amp. Later on, electronics got more. I think we're good.
Yeah, so everybody has that. So before we start building stuff, there's some real quick basics on soldering. Each of you has a soldering iron. There's kind of like two main things you have to worry about. Don't burn each other. So be very careful. No, you're laughing. But seriously. This is a safety concern. Don't burn each other. Be careful. Don't get into a wild conversation where you're really flinging a soldering iron, because you will hurt people or yourself. Also, be careful not to burn the cables of the soldering iron, because that happens a lot. The other thing, basic soldering practice, when you solder two points together, you want to put a little bit of solder on each point. You don't want to just kind of connect the points and then drop solder into there. What you want is to have each point have solder on it, and then you kind of put them together and just gently melt the solder of the two points together. Then
maybe what I can suggest is those that haven't got so much experience with soldering come over here, do an introduction on this, they don't trust their current. And maybe the procedure of things, that's also, for those that have experience of that, of this, right? For those that don't, what you start, because this board, there is a smart first starts to build up this board, and that means you start with the smallest part, build up the largest part. You solve something.
That's the easy part.
It doesn't really matter. So, most of these connections are double-sided. That means by putting in your component, either you take the opportunity of putting flat on the tape, which always helps, or what I do is I use just a tiny little, with this it doesn't matter because you put it on the tape, but if you use another component, you slightly angle the legs, right, you put in one of these here, without looking too much, you slightly angle it, it doesn't pull out, that's an obstruction. So, and then, you solder on both sides of the top, but there is already solder, so these are already pre-soldered, right? So if you look at a PCB, there is already solder on these things here, right? If for instance here there isn't, I mean this is also solder, here there isn't so much, so here I would actually, I'm going to solder something here, I would put solder on first, quickly, make sure it glows, take it away, so this is like the underneath. So here, I mean, this is all, it's not tiny, but it's small enough. Always make sure that you solder it clean this tip. You want to find an angle which is roughly 45 degrees, and it depends on what sort of tip you have, so that you touch the bottom part of it, and you touch the connector part. Then you put a little bit of soldering in the soldering iron so that you make sure that it comes. 45 degrees, then I count. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the reason why I'm saying this is because the important thing is that you get enough solder on it, because if you don't put enough on it, you will see it's a dry soldering part, right? It's a dry point. And the dry point is going to break some of it. So a dry point will break sooner or later, right? So, and by definition, a good soldering point is something that looks a bit like a cone, right? So it's not, well, I would much rather take a medium. 3, make sure it gets heated. 4, comes out. So what's not a good strategy is, and personally, I clean it every, not with these, I mean, here I would go through chuck, and I would clean. So not a good strategy is this here. Okay, that's about. I'm probably just lucky, but for instance, these are double joints. Now, if you can look at the difference between one of them and the other one. One of them has made sure that it flowed to the other side. I think it's this one here.
Yeah.
And this one I just sort of glued. So gluing will work probably, but will not survive, because mechanically, when you move things, sooner or later it's going to break. So it's a very simple. I mean, it's a simple skill, but just to try and explain what, you know, how to take care of, I think the counting works for me, you know. 1, 2, 3. 3 is the main part, so you take it off, and you still keep the iron there, because then solder will fall, then you take it off altogether again. That's the secret. So, let's do another one. 1, 2, 3. And I mean, now I saw it didn't stop to flow while I was putting solder on it, so then I thought, like, well, okay, I'm not done with my 2, let's take another one. If I put too much on it, right, it says a long time. Well, here it will just run on underneath it here, so that's.
There we also
I'm Ja, want terwijl we hoorden, ik hoorde net van niet van Veronica, maar ze hadden het toch wel. Dus sta jij er goed op, Edwin? Is dit het? Everybody was like invited by Nick. I put down all the names of everybody on the list. I hope I didn't make mistakes. And if I did, you can embellish on your own individuality during your presenting yourself. It's a conference. It's a yearly conference about new interfaces for musical expression. And actually, you can say that it's a conference that does the same thing as Time does. And there was an education meeting. As well there, and well, in this meeting I was participating, but also some people from Stein, and they said it would be nice if we had this kind of session more maybe directed to the Dutch situation. But anyway, it would be nice to have a session like this on the Stein Festival. So that's the reason why we are here. The main reason for this session is to learn from each other, I think, to have a little bit of an idea whether we could mean something for each other. Also, to exchange things now and the future of this education, and maybe if it's handy to create a platform for this kind of education, and I would say in the Netherlands, because from the Nine community already, something is starting to grow. So, in this session, my idea was to have a short presentation by everybody. Just tell about yourself and also what your institution does in STEM-related courses, if that's relevant. And also, if possible, what I would like is that you could give one to good start point for discussions. Maybe we have time for some practical issues, like exchanging material or knowledge or whatever. And then we can also discuss whether we should meet more often. I will go to my institution very short, so you have an idea what you could do. And from the HKU, School of the Arts in Utrecht. And there's Faculty Art, Media, Technology, that's in Hilversum. And I am from the Department of Music Technology. And well, this is about STEM-related subjects. The mission of the school is to educate young students up to a level of skills and knowledge and to a level of professional attitude good enough to work and survive within the Dutch context and within the international context. And why I named this mission especially is because the whole system is based on the work field. So it's a lot of practical way of teaching. A lot of projects are coming from the outside world or are based in the outside world and so on. So this is also one of our philosophies, like when you have a lecture, the professor mostly thinks that everybody understands what's happening and the students experience something totally different. And that's why we have